My name's Sarah, and today we are going to be doing a super weird video considering what you consider weird. I was planning on reorganizing my cabinet of curiosities, which is basically the shelves behind me, which is like my big display in my living room of all my little collected oddities, antiques, taxidermy, and stuff like that. I'm still working on my collection. Not all of it is in these shelves, and yeah, like cabinets of curiosities are ongoing projects. They can cost so much money, and so like it's only realistic that it takes a lot of time. I mean, you put a lot of soul into it, so because there's so much stuff you could collect. So I've got collections of antique photos. I have so many that I need to frame, but I can't find the perfect frame for them. I've got some taxidermy. I'm starting up my own taxidermy collection. I'd like some bigger pieces though. And when I first started, I was really, really obsessed with dental oddities. So I have quite a few necklaces with teeth on them and stuff like that, as well as actual dental molds from the 50s and stuff. But I guess you'll see a little bit of that. So basically what I'm going to be doing is taking everything out of my shelves and just reorganizing it. Because every time I get something new, whether it's small or big, I'll typically just place it onto my shelves in a place that it might look good, but overall it just gets unorganized, and then I'll have to take everything out and reorganize it again. So it's a really good experience for me. It sounds really strange, but I get to take everything out, reorganize it, and make it look just like perfect and present those little pieces that I really, really enjoy. I also really want to incorporate my guitar amplifier into my shelves so that it can just be like sitting up there, look really presentable, and kind of just be practical as well as pretty. It sounds kind of strange wanting to incorporate a piece of technology into a collection of antiques and oddities, but I feel like it'll work. I feel like I'm gonna make this work. Also, my partner has this really strange addiction to Lego. So he likes to jam all his Lego in front of all my beautiful oddities. So I'm going to be removing them and trying to kind of like work them in a little bit. It looks a little bit strange, but you can see like right behind me. I've got my little altar here with my mirror and some pentagrams and stuff like that. And then I've got a big model of the first like USS shuttle, whatever it's called, in Lego form, and it kind of fits in there, so I feel like I can kind of make this work. Welcome back. My battery died, so I kind of just chucked it all together at once, and this is the final product. I'm like okay with it. I needed to take out some of the pieces that were the larger framed pieces that were kind of used, I generally use as like a base for like the smaller pieces because I wanted to build that little wall that you might see soon. And there are some pretty amazing pieces, but I'm left with like a lot of smaller stuff that I kind of had to chuck together. So like I'm happy with it, but it leaves some space for me to build on my collection, and I'm really excited to get some much bigger pieces. So I have my little amplifier here. It looks pretty cute. I have an antique Victorian doll on it and some taxidermy. I still have my taxidermy back. Is cute because I had to use some of those bigger pieces for my other wall, but it seems pretty cute. I even incorporated a piece of Lego for my partner that I got him for this Christmas, and it's actually a really cool piece of Lego. It's like a ship in a bottle because he collects Lego ships. I also like to incorporate some dried flowers and even some twigs. I think that kind of builds upon the landscape, the shelves a little bit more and adds a little bit more dimension. And I even have like a little corner with all of my teeth displays that you can see right there. They're so cute. My actual like altar here didn't change much because those are my favorite pieces that I'm in love with. So I have my wildflowers and my mount, and I've got my favorite portrait, The Invisible Girl by Stephen McKay, and then I have a signed picture of Hellraiser here. Yeah, so that's it. Let me know what you thought, and if you liked it, do you think I made much of a difference, or does it look the same? Let me know. Follow me on Instagram, Sarah Walrus. Check me out on my blog, thewalrusroomblog.com, and don't forget to subscribe.